Good evening. The state television company of Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. Indigenous Peoples International Court declares the two papal bulls null and void. 150-year-old millstone discovered in Kharberd, province of Western Armenia. In Kars, because of the cold, vegetation is covered with hoar. Genocide against Armenians Resolution scheduled for a vote in U.S. Congress. The Aleppo Museum opens its doors again after the restoration. The Indigenous Peoples International Court is a court of last resort whose decisions are not subject to appeal. The IPIC operates under the authority of the Global Indigenous Peoples Competent Authority. Indigenous Peoples International Court declares the two papal bulls null and void. In the case brought before the Indigenous Peoples International Court by the collective government of the Indigenous Peoples of the NULL and partners of the First Peoples Development of Trinidad and Tobago against Pope Francis, representing the Holy See, the Vatican, the Catholic Church and its institutions. The petitioners represented by the Global Platform for the Provision of the Effective Remedies, Recourse and Redress regarding historical and contemporary injustices committed against Indigenous peoples called on the Indigenous Peoples International Court to declare the two bulls of Pope Alexander VI dated May 3, 1493 and May 4, 1493 null and void. The petitioners argued that the implementation of the said papal bulls is responsible for historical contemporary injustices committed against the indigenous peoples. Their heirs and successors are also guilty for receiving stolen properties. The Indigenous Peoples International Court, having thoroughly examined the evidence before it, ruled that the two bulls of Pope Alexander VI of May 3, 1493 and May 4, 1493 are null and void. By order of the IPIC, signed Albert Detterville, President of the Indigenous People International Court. In the Toraman village of Kharberd, province of Western Armenia, villagers have found a millstone that is believed to be 150 years old. The millstone was removed with the help of the construction machine and taken under the protection of the villagers. According to one villager, a large mill had previously operated at the site of the millstone, which had heard from the elders of the village. There were Armenians living in the area before, and the findings belonged to Armenians. The Kharberd Museum administration mentioned that the millstone will be examined. In Sarıkamış province of Kars, Western Armenia, the vegetation has been covered with hoar during the night. In Sarıkamış during the night, the air temperature reached -3 degrees, and in the morning, the forest area, small waterways and plants were covered with white hoar. This rarely encountered natural occurrence at the time of year created a pretty view. Genocide against Armenians Resolution is scheduled for a vote in U.S. Congress. Earlier Thursday, the leadership of the Congressional Caucasus on Armenian Issues, Adam Schiff, Gus Bilirakis, Frank Pallon, Peter King, and Jackie Spire released a statement welcoming the move to schedule a vote next week. As the leadership of the Congressional Caucasus on Armenian Issues, we are very pleased that 296 resolution recognizing and memorizing the genocide against Armenians will receive a vote next week by the full House. The genocide, which lasted from 1950 to 1923 and killed 1.5 million Armenians, as well as many other religious and ethnic minorities, was recorded in real time by American diplomats and is supported by historical records, said the Congressional Caucasus leaders. Too many Americans are unaware of the first genocide of the 20th century, as well as the massive humanitarian response led by the United States, which saved countless lives. At a time when Turkey has launched a campaign into northern Syria, which has killed hundreds and displaced hundreds of thousands of civilians, it is all the more important that the House speak clearly and directly about crimes against humanity, whether they occurred a century ago or in the present day. Next week, all members of the House can go on record to state clearly the historic fact of genocide, joining 49 U.S. states and many our closest allies that have already taken this important step, added the Congressional Caucasus leaders. The Museum of Aleppo, the second most famous in the country after the Damascus Museum, resumed work on Thursday after reconstruction for the first time since 2013. The restoration was carried out with the support of the UN Development Program and the Government of Japan. According to the press release to the Syrian Ministry of Tourism received by RIA Novosti, at least 50,000 artifacts are in the museum's storage facilities. During Syrian war, exhibits were transported to the National Museum of Damascus. Aleppo Museum opened in 1931, a new building was erected in 1966. The National Museum of Damascus reopened to visitors on October 28, 2018. Now let us represent to your attention a song Duk Jose Glerner. Page of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.